The time has come for repentance, and the time has come for us to preach the gospel.
Don't be asleep. Arise and awaken. Don't be lazy. Be full of life.
Will you accept it, or will you reject it, or will you smile? Each problem that we encounter, solution is always
helped in the wrong way. If you want to silence your enemies, give up and watch what the Lord will do.
Welcome back to Revelation Time. I just want to give God thanks and praise. I just want to greet the Holy Spirit. He's charge in our life. He's God. And without the Holy Spirit, we are nothing. And we just thank the Holy Spirit. We just thank all our listeners. You're listening on Romy Radio. Amen. Positively power pack. Amen. And also YouTube and Facebook, and all our listeners globally, whether it be China, Colombia, Africa, Uganda, Jamaica, wherever you are, we just thank the Lord for you. Now this morning, I just want to give you a word of encouragement. And, you know, most people are going through problems, and we're in a season where, you know, many want to give up. You know, you're wondering, Lord, what am I going through, what I'm going through? You know, it seems as if each day you make a step forward. You know, it's obstacle and hindrances. And there are things that promise and there are things that prophesy over your life, which have never come to pass as yet, and some of you want to give up on that vision and give up on that dream. So your word today is comfort from John 11, Lazarus comfort. And you can put your name personally, whatever your name, whether your name Suzette, whether your name Beverly, whether your name Maxine, whether your name John, the word is comfort. Now, the scripture said, now there was a certain man that was sick named Lazarus of Bethany, amen, the town of Mary and her sister Martha, amen. It was that Mary which was anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair, and whose brother Lazarus was sick. Therefore, his sister sent unto him, saying, Lord, behold, he whom you love is sick. And when Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Now, there are many people that are going through, whether you're going through sickness, whether you're going through poverty, whether you're going through lack, you know, whatever you are going through, God is saying to you this morning that He is the resurrecting power. And whatever you are going through is not to death, but for the glory of God. So even when people may put you down and they may believe, you know, we have you at a place, you are buried and it is over, that is when God getting ready to resurrect the situation in your life that seems dead. Amen. Because Jesus Christ is the resurrection and the life. And then after that, he said to his disciple, let us go into Judah again. And his disciples said unto him, Master, the Jews have laid sought to stone you, and you are going there again. And Jesus answered, there are 12 hours in a day. If any man walk in the day, stumble not, because he sees the light of the world. Now, when we are Christian, and the light is shining, our light is shining, regardless of what darknesses or dark forces that are there, the light of Christ will protect us. We don't have to worry, because Christ shines in us. And we are the light and the salt of the earth. So wherever we go, darkness, regardless of what trap or plot they may set for you, God is able to deliver you, because there are light that is shining through you. But he said, if a man walk in the night, he stumble, because there is no light in him. Amen? No light in him. And these things said he, and after that he said unto them, our friend Lazarus sleep, but I go that I may wake him up out of his sleep. Amen? Then said his disciple, Lord, if he sleep, he shall do well. So they did not know that Jesus was actually saying, they didn't understand what Jesus was saying, that Lazarus was dead. Amen? Albeit Jesus spoke of his death. But they thought that he had spoken of taking a rest in sleep. Then said Jesus unto them plainly, Lazarus is dead. And I'm glad for your sake that I was not there, to the intent that you may believe. Nevertheless, let us go unto him. Then said Thomas, which is called Didymus, unto his fellow disciple, let us also go, that we may die with him. Amen? Then when Jesus came, he found that he had laid in the grave 4 days already. Amen? What it means is that on the fourth day of death, decomposition begin to set in. So there is no doubt about the death of this man. And 4 means sign, and 4 means season, and it also means balance and globally. Now Bethany was near unto Jerusalem, about 15 furlong off, and many of the Jews came to Martha and Mary to comfort them concerning their brothers. Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went to meet him. But Mary sat still in the house. Then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if you have been here, my brother had not died. Eventually, she does not seem to think of Jesus as raising her brother from the dead. And that is what happened most time when we are going with situation that we are troubling with. Amen. But I know that even now, whatsoever you ask God, of God, God will give it to you. And Jesus said unto her, your brother shall rise again. And Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. And Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believe in me, though thought he were dead, he shall live. Amen. And whosoever live and believe me shall never die. Do you believe this? And she said unto him, yes, Lord, I believe that you are Christ, the Son of God, which should come into the world. And when she had so said, she went her way and called Mary, her sister, secretly, saying, the Master is come and called for you. As soon as she heard that, she arose quickly and came to him. Now Jesus was not yet come into the town, but he was in the place where Martha met him. The Jews then which were with her in the house and comforted her, when they saw Mary, that she rose up hastily and went out following her, saying, she goes unto the grave to weep there. Then when Mary was come where Jesus was, he saw him, and she fell down at his feet, saying unto him, Lord, if you had been here, my brother had not died. Now, as we read those scriptures, many of us are going through some situation. Amen. And the situation that we are going through, yeah, the enemy may have said it is impossible. Amen. You know, you're a stink, you're decomposed, there are stone, you know, that are planted before you, and it is impossible. But God wants each of you to know that is the God of impossibility. So even when Jesus, delay, you know, it's sometimes we may go and through some stuff, and it seems as if there is no haste. You're saying, God, where are you? Lord, I serve you. God, don't you see what is happening and what is going on? Lord, I'm a Christian. Understand that regardless of what happened and regardless of the circumstances, Jesus is the resurrecting power. So many serve Jesus, but still unclear of who he is. Many serve Jesus, but still unclear of who Jesus is. Now, doubt can allow us to misunderstand what God speaking sometimes. You know, God was speaking to Mary that he's the resurrection and the life, and they thought that Jesus was speaking about the end of the earth when he will come back. Amen. They don't understand that Jesus is the resurrection of the light. And once he speak in your situation, everything have to obey. When God speak, anything have to obey. When God speak in your bank account have to obey. When God speak in your life, your hell come, joy come. Whatever situation God speak to, everything have to obey him, because he's the creator, is a resurrection and a life. Now, Jesus don't have to wait until the rapture to raise us up. He can do it now if you believe. So every time you mention the name of Jesus, always speak about life and resurrection. And I say it again, life and resurrection. So whatever die, it could be vision, you know, that God has given you, and it seems as if it is dead. No, it's the resurrection and the life. It could be some stuff that you are waiting on for years. Amen. And it seems impossible. It's the resurrection and the life. It could be that child that you are believing God to bring through your womb. It's the resurrection and the life. It could be a miraculous miracle that you need. Amen. In your life, to resurrect that dead relationship that you thought died. No, is the resurrection and life. And, you know, God wants you to know that nothing is impossible with him. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. And God wants you to understand that regardless of your circumstances, regardless of what's taking place in your life, when man write you off, amen, if they bound your hands and bound your feet and put something over your face, when God said loose, you are loose. Amen. And I'm speaking this morning upon the authority of Jesus that you are loose. I speak that that stone will roll away. I speak even now that as you are buried and, you know, many things that you are stink and it is impossible, that you will see the miraculous things that will take place. Amen. I call forth your name this morning, whatever your name is. As Jesus has said, Lazarus, come forth. I speak that your finance will come forth. I speak that your church will come forth. I speak that your health will come forth. I speak that your joy will come forth. I speak that your circumstances will change. Regardless of what people are saying, that it is finished, I hear to tell you that it cannot finish when you have the resurrection and the life. Amen. Whatever dead can be resurrected this morning. Amen. Your vision is about to resurrect. Your zeal is about to resurrect. Your ministry is about to resurrect. The thing that they have robbed you is about to resurrect. As Jesus saying this morning, call your name, comfort. Amen. Comfort. He said, Lazarus, comfort. He's saying, apostles, comfort. prophet comfort, evangelist comfort, pastors comfort. Amen. I speak to your health to comfort. I speak to your circumstances to comfort. I speak for your husband to comfort. I speak for your wife to comfort. I speak for your children to be safe and comfort. I speak for your document to comfort. God said, I'm resurrecting it this morning. And as you believe, you will receive. You remember, the situation that you are going through, the lack that you are going through, amen, is not to embarrass you, but God will get the glory in your life. Amen. His Father will get the glory. And this morning, let the light of God begin to shine and let God's glory begin to manifest as you rise out of your grave. Amen. I prophesy that your grave is open this morning. Your resurrection has come before the resurrection. Amen. We're not going to wait until the resurrection, well, the rapture. But this morning I speak, amen, that you will be loose because Jesus' word said so. Amen. Comfort, amen, out of your grave cloth. Comfort out of your pity party. Comfort out of your circumstances. Comfort, building comfort, house comfort, car comfort, soul's comfort. I prophesy it even now. Koto rabasata rababababasata. Just lay on upon your body this morning, upon your belly, and said, comfort, call your name. Comfort. Eko rasata rabababasata. Amen. Money that hold to your comfort. Shaka lie that told against you. Exposure. I speak this morning. Eko rabababasata. Rando dobo sata katala baba 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 sata. That guess what? The length of period that you have in your grave has nothing to do with God is about to say do. When all sins that is lost, all God wants you to do is to trust Him and understand that He is the resurrection and the life. He bring peace. He bring unity. He restores us even when we think everything is finished. And I speak the resurrecting power will resurrect every dead things in you this morning. Resurrection even now. And each and every one that are listening right now, you will feel a miraculous power of God in your body right now. And you can call us a testimony. We thank you, Lord, for Jesus' name this morning for resurrecting the dead things in people's life. Curse is broken and hope restored. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you all from Revelation time. Comfort.